Hi, good evening. I haven't seen some of you for a long time. I hope you enjoy your holiday. Okay, we're going to go straight into chapter 3, Being Mindful in Daily Life. So please open your book and we read a little bit from the text, from 109 until 128. Okay, we should wear what is suitable and appropriate for our age and within our family's means. Okay, when eating and drinking, okay, do not be fussy, eat only the right amount, do not overeat, until 132. Okay, so start with 109 until 132. Okay, hey, ready? Go. Chapter 3, Being Mindful in Daily Life. Get up early and go to bed at a reasonable time. Knowing how time flies, we should treasure every day. When we get up, we should wash our face and brush our teeth. After using the toilet, we should always wash our hands. Our head should be properly put on, clothing correctly buttoned, and socks and shoes neatly worn. We should put our clothes away in their proper places. We should not leave them lying around, for they will get dirty that way. It is more important that our clothes be neat and clean than fashionable and expensive. We should wear what is suitable and appropriate for our age and within our family's means. When eating and drinking, do not be fussy. Eat only the right amount, do not overeat. Okay. Should we attempt to read in Chinese? There are phonetics. We'll try. Follow the phonetics. If you can't make it out, the sound is okay. We'll try, okay? Jing. Zhao qi zao. Ye mian shi. Lao yi zhi. Xi chi shi. Chen bi guan. Jian shu. 口便要回折净手关闭正扭闭结袜与履俱紧切置官服有定位勿乱顿置污秽衣贵洁 不贵华上旬分下称家对饮食勿俭则时事可勿过则好 See, it's so much easier in Chinese. Three words convey all the same words in English. So don't worry, you get a hang of it, block by block, like word for word. Okay, now this chapter is about actually how to manage, our daily, routines and some of the attitudes we should have when we do things. One of the very important attitudes we should hold in life is know how to manage our time. So today, if I ask you, are you busy? This is almost a very useless question, isn't it? Are you busy? Of course you are busy, right? So I should ask you, so what are you busy about today? What did you do today? Then you have to think, what did I do today? I'm not sure what did I do today, right? We're really busy. That the busy has become, blindly doing things that we are not remember, mang. We're not even sure what we are busy about, because we don't seem to be able to control our time, to manage our time. So the young child who studied this must learn actually how to manage their time. Starting from where? Starting from the bedroom. Okay, tidying up their bed, tidying up their closets, okay, their playhouse, okay, and also doing routines that they don't like, but which they have to be trained to do, okay, to take care of their appearance, their hygiene. So time management is very important. I think ever since we're young, our parents will tell us what? 早睡早起,精神好. 有没有听过? 有哦。 还有呢? 还有什么东西跟我们说一定要早睡的? 早起的小鸟有虫吃。 所以要早一点呢,出来呢,比较好。 那么,这个景也是一样的, 所以第一件事他要教的, 就要教我们怎么样呢? 珍惜时间。 不要明日复明日, don't say there's always tomorrow. Wait until tomorrow, wait until tomorrow. Okay, whatever we can do today, we will do it today. Whatever we cannot finish, yes, we will do it, continue to do it tomorrow. Okay. Now, 这个早起早夜眠迟, then you say, the Chinese say 夜眠迟, that means what? Go to bed at a later time. Wouldn't it be wonderful? We hear this, wow, 夜眠迟, 可以不用这么早睡, wouldn't it be wonderful? Especially children, who wants to go to sleep early, children? And the nighttime is the best time for me to chat, you know, to do other things. So, 夜眠迟非常好, mommy, 这个弟子规言还不错的. And not bad, mommy, 夜眠迟啊, don't have to go to sleep early. So we must justify this for you, okay? Now, in the ancient time, what is late? 迟是什么呢? 太阳下去就迟了。 Because there were no electricity, you know, they have to burn the kerosene lamp or burn the oil lamp. So for them, it's 迟了. 那可能八点多就是睡觉了。 八点多对他们来讲已经很迟了。So after 8 is already very late for them. So children, they are learned to actually to go and check the doors, check the windows, make sure they are shut, right? And make sure their parents are safely tucked away in their bedroom already. Father and mother are safe. Now I can go to bed. Okay? Of course, now is the other way around. Okay, we always tuck the children first, make sure they are safe, then only, you know, the parents go to the bed. But in the ancient time, children are groomed to take care of their parents ever since they were young. 你从小就要想到照顾你的父母亲, 这是中国古人教孩子的。 处处都要想到爸爸妈妈, 想到爸爸妈妈辛苦了一天, 爸爸妈妈回来, 要让他们好好休息, 要帮他们做事情。 所以夜眠迟呢, 是把所有的门啊, 窗啊, 火啊, 全部熄好了。 而且 in northern China, you know they because during the winter time, I think they even burn the woods inside the house in the kitchen to keep the place warm. So they have to make sure the flames are already put away. 火要把它熄掉啊，然后不可以说 什么就是先去睡觉，那就不孝了。孝子是不会躺着去睡觉，不管父母的，他不可以这样的。所以就是为什么夜眠迟。 那为什么要早呢? 要比父母亲起得早，要去问候父母亲, must go and greet the father and mother. So, 你要站在那个外面先打扫好了，要什么叫父母要等在那边跟父母说父亲早妈妈早, good morning mom, good morning dad, 而不是爸爸妈妈站在我们的床边, hello, wake up. You're going to be late for school. You're going to be late for school. Quick, 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 quick. Mom, let me sleep some more, lah, please. I'm still tired. Quick, I don't know, you miss your bus. You miss your ride or something. No, 孝子不可以，不应该这样的。啊，因为呢，孝子呢 ，do not worry, do not make the parents worry。你做个孝子，不能够让爸爸妈妈担心的，让爸爸妈妈担心是很不孝的。所以从小小孩子要这样教啊，要教他，哎，说这个不能够让爸爸妈妈不安心，要让他爸爸妈妈能够安心才是啊，就是孝顺。所以他必须怎么早起早。朱子治家格言说嘛 ，the maxims of 朱子 said， 一早就什么打扫庭除，一早起来就要打扫这些阔呀，打扫这些房间的。打扫完了之后呢，做完之后呢，啊，要什么就跟啊这家人呐、啊、就一起啊这个说声好一些。So these are very good kind of practice to train a child, one to be filial and two to be responsible, like from the very young age. Always think for the father, always think for the mother. And from a practical point, I find that if we wake up early, let's say at 5 in the morning, the day seems to be longer, we seem to have more time to do things. I find that if I wake up at 7 or 8,Suddenly, it is afternoon already. And suddenly, it's nighttime already. Right? So, 一定要抓紧那个早上的时间 to do that. And, you know, don't you think it's funny, but 这个 when we get up, we should wash our face and brush our teeth. Do you not think this is something that we do all the time? Right? But why is it put there? It's to remind ourselves of the hygiene. Something that is very simple, but something we should do.And not skip in our life, our appearance, our hygiene. After using the toilet, we should always wash our hands. I remember during the SARS period, when SARS was almost become an epidemic, remember they remind us to wash our hands? Right? Kevin reminded you must wash your hands. But if your child has learned 弟子规, he already knows that. She already knows that, that she doesn't have to be reminded again.Why you have to be reminded again? Because children may not have this habit. But this way, you know, teach them, okay, 你一定要把它洗手，而且我们教孩子洗手也有方法的哦。那我们怎么洗啊？
How do you normally wash your hands? Like that, right? Then, or, not that I cross up. That's okay.That's how you wash it, right? And then all of a sudden, they went, my own. That's how it goes, okay? So children, they should give them a handkerchief, right? A handkerchief. And to wash their hands, when they wash, they wash this one, the upper part of the left, the upper part of the right, and then the upper hand of the left arm, and the upper hand of the right arm. 要这样洗的，不是？擦，然后通通通通通，哦 ，like that, like that.And then go on. So in the class, in the children's class, they are being taught like to wash their hand properly, not to splash the water all over the place, okay, and not to wipe their hand on their body, okay, or use their sleeves, right? Oh no, usually they do this.
Certainly, you know, Chinese are being seen as a very ethnic group who is not very clean and tidy.When I was in San Francisco, I think in the 1980s, I first went to San Francisco Chinatown. I hope it has changed now, okay? It was very rowdy, very busy for people, but the streets were less tidy. And then when I went to Japanese village, it was so tidy. It was so neat and so quiet. And what a big contrast.And everywhere there were Chinese, you know, in the restaurant, they become very noisy. So we give people the impression that we are very noisy. Do you agree? Or you need to protest? This is not true. We are actually very quiet and cultured. I can't say that because whenever they are Chinese, we tend to be very, very loud. I was talking to somebody who lived in Japan, you know, most of her life,And she told me that in Japan, you know, people do not speak loudly in public transport, okay, in public area, which I agree because I was in the subway during the peak hour. And there's all the story I heard about, you know, how you squeeze people into the Japanese, you know, express train, and you just get sandwiched right inside. It's true. Because I was standing there, and it was an express train. Express train means that they only start from your original point and then go to a destination. It doesn't stop at any other places. And it was just packed with people. I thought I was going to suffocate. But there were so many people, okay. And I was standing there. I didn't have to hang on to anything. There was no way place for me to put my hand on. Okay? But don't worry, I didn't have to trip because I was surrounded by people. So when I leaned to the left side, there was a guy. When I leaned to the right side, there was a woman. When I leaned backward, there would be someone else at the back. Then when I leaned forward, there was someone in the front. So I was pretty safe, but I was like, I can't breathe. And also, I also heard that Japanese men have a habit of going and have one or two drinks after they finish work. I'm not sure whether this is right or not, but the man standing in front of me definitely had a few drinks. And because like his height was about my height, you know, he wasn't very tall, and he was breathing all this alcohol, you know. And in front of me, I was like, please open the door. Please open the door. But throughout, I did not hear anybody talking. People were quiet, very quiet people. And I went to a restaurant, and also they were very quiet, except when they drink. When they drink, they became very rowdy. But if they don't drink, they seem to be very orderly and quiet. I don't know what happened to Chinese when they drink, worse or better? Maybe you guys can tell me, worse or better? Huh? Worse, huh? Oh, okay. And then everybody had a yum say, you know. Oh boy, is it like, they give people the impression that we are untidy, we are loud, and we are gamblers. I was talking to my Canadian, friend and grandmother. They'll ask me the first thing, is it true Chinese are gamblers? I said, well, I'm a Chinese. I'm not a gambler. Maybe you are different. That's what we heard. Is that true? I said, unfortunately, most Chinese like to gamble. Gamble doesn't mean that you throw the dice or you go and go to Genting or something, okay? But it also means like stock speculation. It's also a kind of gamble.